Well, we'd have to come in early in the morning, and Radio City, you load in off of the street, and everything actually comes in, gets rolled in off the street. There's a short little elevator that drops everything down to the stage. So you're talking about all the risers for the band. You're talking the whole PA system. At that time, Radio City didn't have a sound system installed. They do now. And you would literally start, you know, we would usually try to get a half a day before, just because it takes, you know, 4 hours just to get the stuff into the building. And then you got to hang it, and then you've got to, you know, hang the lights, set up the staging, all the risers, all the music stands, mic the whole band up. We worked with Frank a lot of times at Radio City. They actually had a band cart that they would use there for their Christmas show. And one thing that's great about Radio City is the fact that they have these three sets of elevators from the downstage to the upstage edge. And they're sort of hydraulic system, and actually the original aircraft carriers that were designed during World War II were designed off the technology from the elevators at Radio City Music Hall. And there was a period of time there, from what the guys tell me there, that it was kind of classified, where people couldn't come in and see how those things actually ran, because they were building the elevators for Radio City. But one thing great about that room is that we would use that band cart, and we would load the band in elevator three upstage, and they would start playing the overture, and the band cart would literally rise out from the stage and then travel downstage. But we'd have to wire that whole band cart up, mic it up, and obviously when we would mic up everything individually there, because when the music actually starts playing and they're in the elevator, you wouldn't be hearing nothing, you know? Yeah. There would be usually be a box square lighting truss around the 20-foot stage area on the floor, and I would hang monitors off of that facing down to him, which would be kind of a mirror image of the PA, which is actually going towards the audience. And I would put a general mix in there of the whole band, you know, and with him obviously a little louder than that. And that relationship of what I learned of where that band needed to be in his monitors, in opposed to where he needed to be, was exactly what we were discussing before, as to how he would be able to trail off and know exactly where he was, and without me having to lift him. So that's how we did it. We did it with flying monitors on that, and putting a couple wedges around the floor. And it was actually a pretty unique thing, because in those days, to have an orchestra, we would fly the PA in the round, like 48 boxes around. And the technology and the size of the boxes, when we first started, were not as streamlined and small as they are now, small and mighty. And you would have, you know, 60 open microphones in the field of the PA. So that's kind of where I cut my teeth, learning how to equalize the system properly so that nothing would be squealing or feeding back or whatever.